the evening. This gentleman is everywhere and everywhere and everywhere and goddamn everywhere. He's great, he's on your television, he's doing storytelling, he's on your bookshelves. Lose your fucking mind for Mr. James Gordon, ladies and gentlemen.
Sorry. What's up? Come to the room with me and your mom. So go to the room, sitting there, a man. He says, son, we're transferring you schools. I said, yes! Because I knew it was the Holy Angels. He says, I'm so glad you, he says, Bobo, I'm so glad you're taking it so well, because we're transferring you to Bradwell. Bradwell was the worst public school on the south side of Chicago at that time. It was like a high school building, and it just had grammar school classes in it. You go there, and like I said, all the kids at St. Bride's were small, like me. This was like me walking into Jurassic Park. I don't know what those kids were eating and drinking, but that shit was differently from what I was eating and drinking. They were giants. And there were now no longer 14 or 15 in the class. There were 25, 26, 30 plus people in the class. So the teacher knew your name, could match you and your name. That was a blessing. And here I was in this new jungle. So my mom, trying to make my transition easier, she did what she only did on field trips. She made my lunch every day. So she would get a brown paper bag and make two peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and cut them down the middle. She put an apple, a pear, some sort of fruit, a chocolate chip cookie, and she gave me 25 cents for the greatest creation ever. Chocolate milk. Oh my God, chocolate milk. you gotta understand. White milk is, you know you need it in cereal and everything, but there's just something very angelic about chocolate milk. And I always had this myth, don't judge, that the more I drank chocolate milk, the darker my skin got. So you're probably saying, you drank a lot of motherfucking chocolate milk, right? I did. Now, I didn't know what love was in sixth grade, but I used to watch The Love Boat. I dated the shit out of myself, I'm telling y'all that. And it felt like that, so I loved chocolate. It was the bestest thing ever. So every day, 12:05 p.m., myself and the rest of sixth graders, we'd go downstairs and do what sixth graders do at lunchtime. We eat our lunch, and sometimes Trey was in the bags. We complained about all the homework and looked forward towards the weekend. And it was one of two best times of the day, the other one being gym. And all was good. Till about 12:25, he would come. He was Eric. Eric the bully. And Eric's favorite thing to eat at lunchtime was whatever you had in your lunch. If you had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich cut down the middle, that was Eric's favorite sandwich. An apple, pear, some sort of fruit, his favorite fruit, a chocolate chip cookie, his favorite cookie. But his favorite thing for the last 3 weeks has been chocolate milk. Yeah. So he picked on one sixth grader in particular, me. That shit wasn't flying today, because I was really thirsty for my chocolate milk, and my mom didn't give me 25 cents for Eric to drink chocolate milk. She gave it to me, so I drank it, and it was delicious. Circle forward to 3 o'clock. I look across at Eric sitting two rows over, and he gives me the universal sign that he's going to beat me up at 3:15. I look across at Eric sitting two rows over at 3:10 p.m. He again gives me the universal sign he's going to beat me up at 3:15. But at 3:12 p.m., something very strange happens. When I look across at Eric sitting two rows over, I give him the sign that I'm going to beat him up at 3:15. Now, I got to explain to you why this is odd. Eric had failed the sixth grade twice. He came in at 6'2", 187 pounds. Shit is the operative word that somebody said. It is now 3:14:55. I grab my Batman back book bag. Love Batman. It's everything. My Chicago Cubs baseball hat. 3:14:56. 3:14:57. Boom! I'm out of my chair, out the door before the teacher says class dismissed. Now it's one, two flights, three flights of stairs, and I'm out to school, and I've gotten away from Eric. But as I told you, Eric has failed sixth grade twice. He's bigger, stronger, and faster than the rest of the sixth graders, and he's right behind me, running down Saginaw to 78th Street. I make a right. In the alley, I think I can lose him. I make a left. Look over my shoulder. He's right behind me. I get over the fence, Mrs. Johnson's yard, and today of all day, the Doberman Pinscher is free. Somehow or another, I get past the animal, back to the other side of the fence, to Saginaw, and I say a prayer. I say, Lord, would you please let the dog eat Eric? Eric, as I told you, is spelled the sixth grade twice. He's bigger, stronger, faster than the rest of us sixth graders. He's arguably the best athlete in the school. So he's over the fence, mushes the Doberman Pinscher over the fence again, and right behind me, headed towards 79th Street, where I see salvation. My mother, the greatest woman I have ever known, is standing in front of the house, partner villain, standing there, and she's smiling and waving, and I'm like, oh, I'm saved. But telepathically, I send my mother a message. I said, Mom, could you stop smiling and waving and do something? Don't you see this monster who failed in sixth grade twice, who wants to beat me up because I didn't get my chocolate milk today? Mom, help! My mom, as I told you, the greatest woman I have ever known, reads to her son every night, helps him get comic books when it's not allowance time. She's just wonderful. I know she's going to come through. So she continues to smile and wave. I am on my own. As most things are on the south side of Chicago, the streets are decrepit, and the sidewalks on this particular street reflect the streets, and it's rained for the last 2 days, so it's like a giant moat in front of me. To not get anything on my school clothes, I go through the grass. Eric sees this opportunity, he runs to the water, but he trips up, falls, boom, splash! I keep running. In situations like this, there are jackals disguised as other children. They never help, they never call for help, they never do anything, they never say anything. They just point and laugh at whoever they think is losing. And that happens to be Eric at this time, but I don't join them, I don't even watch. I'm still running, trying to get some safe distance between he and I. Finally, I run into my mother's arms, and I turn. And that is the moment that Eric is rising from the water, drenched, soaking, angry, seething, and we lock eyes. Eric realizes that he will never again drink my chocolate milk. And I realize, for that to be true, there will be days that I will stand and fight and get my ass kicked. But today, I ran from the bully. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen,